The motion trail effect is one of the coolest effects that you can possibly create. You've probably seen it in award-winning films like The Matrix, but today I'm going to show you how to do this in Filmora. Stick around, I'll show you how.
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
So I've got two video clips here, one of some people walking through a park with a dog running alongside them. And the second clip that I have is just a guy swinging a golf club. To start with this clip of the people in the park and the dog, let's bring our footage down into the timeline, let's right click and copy on it, and then let's paste it into tracks right above this. I'm gonna start with four tracks to give the idea of what I'm doing here. Now, if I just hit play from the beginning, because these are all stacked, it would all look like the same video playing through with no added effect. But here's what we wanna do. Start with the track right above your main track. Let's double left click on that, and then up in the video tab, let's open up the compositing tab from the dropdown. In the menus, it defaults to normal, but let's scroll down and select pin light. And then let's roll back our percentage of opacity to about 30%, give or take. And now let's do the same thing with the tracks above that. Number three track, pin light 30%. The number four track, pin light at about 30%. Now here's where it gets interesting. Let's stretch this out in our timeline and let's grab the number two track and drag it back by about 10 frames. What'll happen is when you get to that point, you'll see that basically this track is occurring slightly behind the original. Let's grab the number three track and let's bring that an additional 10 frames out. We'll grab the number four track and do the exact same thing, about 10 frames back. Now, all these tracks only start operating at this point, so that's where we want to begin. Let's take a look at how these tracks now stagger. Kind of cool, huh? Another thing that you can add to this is if you actually click on each track and offset it so it's happening slightly behind, you can create a little more stagger. So for instance, the number two track, let's left click on that down in the timeline. It will highlight up in the upper preview window, and let's use our keyboard left arrow to send this back maybe 5 frames. Then the next track above that will send that back an additional 5 frames, which would be a total of 10. And then the track above that will add another 5 frames, which will be a total of 15 frames back using our left keyboard arrow. Then when we play from this point, you get this cool staggered effect. Now for our golfer segment, what I did was I actually let this play out in normal time until he got to the top of his swing. One of the key things in both of these video segments that you have to understand is that the backgrounds aren't really moving. That's what really helps this effect sell. Now, because it's only his swing that's moving, let's find the top of that swing, right about there, and let's split the footage. Now let's scroll forward to where his swing follows through and ends, right about there, and let's split that one more time. Once we've got this center swing section isolated, let's bring that up by left-clicking and dragging it to the next track above. We're gonna do this because we wanna change the speed of this particular swing. Now, right over here, you can see the speed and duration dial. Let's slow that down to about a quarter of the normal speed. Now, let's take the end segment, move it over, and allow that to drop back into place. So now he'll have a normal speed swing until he gets to that particular part of his full swing, and then it picks back up at the end of his swing. Now let's right click on that slow motion section and choose copy. We'll select the track above, put the playhead right at the beginning of that section, and paste. Let's do that for the next two tracks above it, so we have 3 copies total. And now let's apply a similar effect starting with track 2. Let's double left click on it, and up in the compositing tab, we'll choose pin light and dial it back to about 30%. Let's do the same with the tracks above it. And then when we get to these sections, let's left click and drop each track back about 10 frames or so, depending on what looks right to your eye. Now let's take a look. see how it creates that video echo effect? But we don't want to offset the position in the preview window because we want his body to stay centered. We're not trying to move that. But that gives us this really cool motion trail effect. I have to shout out my pal Skater D from the community for mentioning this idea in the comments section. You guys are the best. I learned just as much from you as you ever learned from me. So keep coming with the great ideas. And stop by his channel and check out his content too. And if you want to learn more Filmora tips, tricks, and techniques, click the video on screen now and the ones I've got pinned down in the description and comments below. Peace.